Let's kick it off right here, right now, with bout number one on the card. Fighting out of the blue corner, Jaxson Mclean.
This kid might just be the most talented person I've ever met.
Wow.
He can wrestle. He can submission wrestle. He can strike. He can spin. He can shoot double legs like you wouldn't believe. If this kid can pull it together and perform under the lights, I'm telling you, we're looking at a future UFC star. He's 18 years old, and he looks like he's been in the game for 10 years. At training, it's all different once you enter the arena though, Frankie, I'll tell you that much.
Wow. Ali Ramahi.
Ramahi. He trains out of the men, he's been wrestling with those boys for a long time, and let me tell you, I believe the men have some of the best wrestling in the country, so he knows what to do. It's just, as I said before, anything can happen when those lights hit you.
Yeah, you would know that.
Mate.
Man,
what you can do at training is so much different to what you can do in a fight. So,
you think it can go both ways? You think it can really bring the best out of you? And also, it can make you be like a deer in the headlights as well, right?
I don't think Ali will be like a deer in the headlights. Like, this kid just cries and oozes confidence. He loves the crowd. He looks very confident. Both boys look ready to go. I'm super excited for this fight.
On the card, Pass the Hex. We are live! It's my bookie team at Pass the Hex. 3x3 minute rounds in the Hex. Flyweight division.
3 minute
rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, 175 centimeters tall, with an official weight of 56.7 kilograms. Tonight, he makes his cage debut, fighting out of Gracie Baja in the Hunter Valley, New South Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, Jaxson Mclean!
Gracie Baja, my
mistake. Across the cage, his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, this man is a striker, standing 174 centimeters tall, with an official weight of 57.1 kilograms. One fight, one win, fighting out of mid martial arts in Craigieburn and Victoria, ladies and gentlemen, Ali Ramahi! When the action begins, the man in charge in the center of the cage, Mr. Greg Clinton.
Ali is so amped up for this.
Mate.
He's screaming, war crying at him.
He's either going to sprint across the cage and try and kill him, or he's going to be nice and relaxed and composed. We're going to see.
Right.
Let me tell you something about Ali. This kid is mean. He wants to hurt people. I saw him at an interclub, and he tried to kick the guy's head off.
No doubt about it. Mate, the boys are both in shape, 57 kilos. Man, this is going to be so exciting. Don't blink. All right, Jimmy, here we go.
Here we go.
Hey, by the way, it's such an absolute honor to be here with you, man. I mean, you've done amazing things for Australian MMA.
Likewise,
and MMA in the world, my friend. So here we go. We're rocking and rolling.
It's my honor, Frankie.
Yeah, Jaxson's going to be cautious for sure.
Yeah, and you know what? Ali is very composed. Good
leg kick. Opens up with a nice inside leg kick.
for Jaxson. Needs to double up those jabs. If he just throws singles, he's going to get picked apart. So I'd like to see Jaxson throw a double jab maybe, throw something behind the jab.
He's got to put something in Ali's face. He can't just let Ali tee off on him like that.
Yeah.
Even if he's just showing him some hands, he doesn't have to put them on him.
Doesn't have to connect.
Yeah, just make sure he's giving him something he's got to worry about. It's just going to make the path coming forward a little more difficult. Ali doing a great job counter-attacking there real quick.
Yeah, he's quick.
These boys are going to be very quick at this weight. Super fast hands.
Good one, Sue, from Jaxson.
Yeah, right up the middle.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to throw him straight down the line and double things up.
Double jab right hand, or even two straight rights and the left hook. Just make sure you give him two down the middle. Ali just missed with that right hand. You know, see some Carstairs in the back over there.
Mate, so he's the best wrestling coach in the country.
He's amazing, right?
He's amazing. He's hitting him and he's just touching him. He's not overexerting himself.
Yeah, Jackson's got to get his head moving, especially when he starts. Ali's coming forward like that. He can't just keep his head straight on top of his shoulders.
No,
it's very dangerous.
He can't. He needs to set up his leg kicks with some punches.
He's a little bit timid and hesitant. You can tell. Who can blame him, right?
10 days' notice, mate.
Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing. Against a guy like Ali. Jeez.
You look at Ali now, and this is his second amateur fight. He's 18 years old. Can you believe that? How composed he is.
It's amazing. His left hand is a little low for my liking, I must admit.
Yeah.
Especially when the gloves are so light. I think they're fighting tonight with a 6 ounce glove.
Yeah, they look like
they look a little bit more. They look like the karate, the 80s, mate. The 80s karate days.
Yeah.
No retreat, no surrender.
Ali's
remember that.
Got to stop throwing singles. If he pops a single, he can get caught. If he throws combinations, he can get back hits.
Spinning back. Oh, nice line there out the top.
Go to the dome. He's just touching him. And I like to see this. He's not,
he's
not trying to kill him with every shot. He's just touching him up, covering him pain. if he had pain on the end of his glove,
he'd just
be
another dab on him, another blob on him, right? Nice. Just a tag. Oh, nice one. He's starting to find his range now. 23 seconds left in this first round. You know, I'd like to see a little bit more lateral movement from Jaxson just for health and safety purposes, you know.
Throw and a takedown.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, he's so heavy on those front legs, right? So he's trying to throw the question mark. Oh, here he comes. Here he comes. Ali throwing big, heavy hands. Oh, he's hurting to the body. Oh, Mclean took it like a champ.
Good round for Ali. He's just touching him. If I'm Jaxson, if I'm in Jaxson's corner, I'm saying you need to mix it up. You just can't keep backing up to the fence, you know.
Yeah.
Even if you feel like you're not a better wrestler, you need to throw him the takedown. You need to somehow gain his respect, whether it's by rushing him with a combination, shooting a takedown. Even if you miss, you get back up and you crack him. You can't just sit with your back against the cage.
No, not at all. And that's what I was saying at the end there. I'd like to see him move around a little more laterally.
Yeah.
Even that he had to follow you, just even to keep you in his crosshair.
Yeah.
I mean, that takes energy as well.
It looks like he's trying to play a counter game. You've got to get the guy to chase you. So if you move laterally, the guy's going to chase you. If you just stand there, he doesn't have to chase. And he can sit still. But if you move laterally, especially in this level, mate, he might not know to cut the ring. He might start chasing, so, you know, if I was in his corner, that's what I'd be saying.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Here we go. Round two, Jimmy. Round two. Let's see some good coaching. And he's this jiu-jitsu guy from Gracie Barr. I'm wondering when that takedown's coming.
Yeah. So I don't know much about him, but if you're from a Gracie Barr high school, you know what you're doing on the ground.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Those of you joining us live on the stream, epicenter.com, share it with your friends, tell your cousins, your uncles, your aunties, your nephews and nieces to get on and check these fights out. This is an awesome, epic amateur event, Path to HEX, Chelsea Heights Hotel. He's moving around a little bit more, he's getting control of that centre.
Mate, he was listening to you.
You reckon? You see Ali just wants to try that overhand, right?
Yeah. I like what he's doing though, he's faking with the overhand right, coming up with the left high, making him worry about that right hand, and then he's looking for that left high kick.
Oh, geez, that's another one down the middle.
That was crisp.
Yeah, that's about the fourth clean right hand that Ali has landed. You know, Jaxson's got to move his head. Well, he's got to. There's the fifth one. All right, so he's got to. Look, his hand's hurting. There's the sixth one. He's got to shoot in for a double. He's got to try and do something here, Jimmy.
You've got to switch it up.
He has to. He's just been predictable.
You can't have your back against a cage.
Very predictable, right?
Yeah, there, so there it is. Even if he doesn't get this, it shows it's there.
Let's see if he can get the fight from the ground. Ali's done a great job.
If it breaks, he needs to throw it. So I think when you break up a takedown and you take a step back, it does nothing. But if you break up a takedown and you take a step forward and throw, it puts pressure on your opponent. I'd like to see Ali go to the body. He's head-hunting a bit. He's hit him in the head a few times. If he drops under the body, just like that.
There you go.
It's going to open up the head a lot more.
Absolutely. Keep changing it up. High and low. Give him different looks. It's hard to get set and set up counters. He's staring down the barrel of many different combinations coming at him. I'll lose that double again.
Mate,
again, Arm is doing a great job.
Great hits.
Yeah.
You expect nothing. Look, he's got Saeed in his corner. Saeed Kaz in his corner. You're going to expect him to have great wrestling.
Absolutely.
Saeed's my wrestling coach. So.
I've been lucky, man. I've called a couple of fights on the Saeed and HEX as well. He loves that arm drag to the back, doesn't he?
Right, yeah. He sort of just like bulldog headlocked him down to the ground there. I didn't really see what happened there.
Yeah, well, here we go. We've got Jaxson on his back. Let's see what kind of guard he's got, or any guard at all for that matter. Ali's on top half, right against the cage. He's looking for an arm and all the blood out here, but Ali's just tossed it up.
I want to see Ali's submission defense. I know his wrestling's very good. I know his submission offense is very good.
Yeah.
I want to see his submission defense.
Well, I don't know exactly if he's allowed to go for a heel hook here, but he's trying to switch it up. Jackson's chasing his legs. Ali defends and stands up.
Something's wrong with his hand.
Again, see, now he's going back to that double. That's good. That's a good tactic.
Hey, you got to switch it up if one thing's not working, and that's what he's done. I knew this fight was going to be good, but what a way to open up an amateur show. This is a very high level amateur fight.
The boys are doing amazing. It's great. Two rounds in.
If I'm in Ali's corner, I'm going to say, I'll say to him, you can take throw high, take the punches to the body. Don't overexert yourself. I think then he's starting to go a bit head hunting crazy. And that's what sort of opened it up to the takedown. So I would like to see Ali sort of go to the body a bit more with his hands. Probably drop the kicks a little bit if this guy's looking to take him down.
Sure.
Jaxson's just got to get him on those hips. That lateral movement you're talking about, Frankie, it's perfect.
He did a lot better in that round. I mean, he did get scored on a few times. I mean, Ali, like you said, he's really chasing the chin. But let's see, this is the last round. Let's see how these boys handle it. 3 minutes to go.
I believe Jaxson needs to finish, so
yeah.
That's what I'd be saying. Get him down and sub him. That's what I'd be saying. Ali's breathing a little bit heavy. Those scrambles, they take. As I was saying before, even if you don't get the takedown, the scrambles take it out of your opponent.
Of course. Your lungs start burning.
Yeah, your body starts fatiguing.
It sure
your
does.
Your technique isn't as good as it was.
Yep.
Your right hands aren't as hard as they were.
Saeed waving him in, waving his fighter in. Pressure. Both boys in the middle.
Jackson's come out a bit stronger this round, but
you think he'd go underneath a couple of those, Jimmy, you know, just to make him miss.
Ali is winging them, so
yeah, it's, you can see it coming, you know.
It's possible to duck under them when they overhand rights are the best thing to take someone down on.
Absolutely. So much power's coming forward, it just falls right into your trap.
That's why I used to get taken down. So
there it is. Oh, he's got his back. Let's see. Oh, he's got a hook in as well.
In.
Oh, this is a beautiful takedown by Jaxson. Mclean. He's trying to get his second hook in.
Ali's scrambling very well, though. He might end up on top here.
He might. Jackson's starting to make a move. He's got to follow his hips. He's got to get up on top.
Jackson's got to abort that and go to flank, I reckon.
He has to get up. He has to follow him up. He's going to lose it. It's going to end up on his back.
A lot of guys, they chase the back control so much and give out a good flank position from turtle position. Unless your hooks are in and you know they're in, you should never jump on the back.
McLean's got an overhook on that side, but he's going to bail on it.
Very nice.
Ali takes advantage of it. Both boys getting tired. Not long now.
Man, Jack, Jaxson's coming back and showing a lot of heart. Something that you can't teach.
He's a tough kid, that's for sure. He's been nailed all night long and he's still coming forward.
He wants to win.
He wants it bad. He knows he has to finish, Jimmy.
Yeah, he has to finish.
You can smell it in his game plan. You can see it. Oh, Ali takes him down.
Nice. See if Ali can compose himself.
Inside 30 seconds for sure. I can't see a time here, but...
Drop his hips. Touch him. Don't overexert yourself. You've got the win. You might want to finish, but...
He's looking for an armbar. You know, McLean's getting underneath that arm. He's starting underneath that arm. I can't see from this area.
Here either.
He's looking. He's trying to attack... Ali's
got to pull
left
out.
Arm.
Ali's just going to pull out and get back to his feet.
Oh, he might have a triangle going on here. He's got great posture control. He's definitely deep on that armbar. I'm watching the referee here. He's out. Oh, now he's laying down some serious punishment. Jaxson's got to do something. He's got to get up and get on with the fight.
He's not going to win from here. Yes, yeah.
Exactly.
He needs a finish. You can't slam your back.
He's two rounds down. He's got to make it happen.
Ali's
just all over him.
All over him.
10 seconds,
Ten
Jimmy.
Seconds to go. You just got to go out with a flying knee. You can't knee at him. Sorry.
Flying armbar.
Superman punch.
Awesome job.
Awesome fight.
Great job.
Good showing. Good showing from both boys. Say he's a crazy, crazy man. Good showing from both boys, you know, coming in off 10 days' notice and taking someone like Ali to the distance.
That says a lot about Jaxson.
This kid's got so much hype behind him. Everyone that knows him says he's the most talented kid they've ever met in the gym.
Wow.
And, you know, he was able to push a pace and win sections of the fight. So, you know, Jackson's got a huge future in the sport. I'll tell you right now, in 5 years down the track, Ali's going to be in the UFC.
I'm looking forward to it, brother. I believe you. Somehow, I believe you.
18 years old, second amateur fight.
Right.
Works hard too.
Now, I'm not sure whether I should be in there interviewing the winner, because no one told me I needed to, and whatnot. I have no microphone, so I'm not sure.
I don't believe
so. I'm not sure. Usually I would, but I'm just waiting. Maybe the truck could tell me whether I should be interviewing anyone. If anyone hears this message, they can relay a message to somebody. Whether I should be in there interviewing the fighter, let me know. No? Keep the show rolling.
Got some fights to get through.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking that as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, the three rounds of action will come to the judges' scorecards. All three judges scored the contest 30. 27, declaring it a fire, unanimous point decision from the red corner, Ali Ramahi.
Pretty dominant win. You know, Jaxson had his moments. He's going to learn a lot from that. Ali's going to learn a lot from that.
Absolutely.
Great. And then when things started going sour, they were good. Back to the table.